let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Thomas McLean has the ball set how he wants it, and we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. Thomas takes it to 12. He's taken down at the 42. Leonard's mental toughness makes him difficult to rattle when he's on the road. And here he is now, Kirk, taking the field for the first time today. Let's see how he does.
And not only does this guy not get rattled, but he's also a guy that seems to have an uncanny ability to quiet a crowd by making such big plays.
Hand off, and he's met immediately.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. He steps out at the 50. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Tries to buy some time. He's tackled around the 42-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Here's the halfback. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. 1 yard loss for the halfback. About the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, it's first down. Tackle made around the 30-yard line.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
From the 33-yard line, third down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's pushed out of bounds around the 29-yard line. So they gain a few yards, but they're nowhere near picking up the first down.
Well, it was third down and long. They had a long way to go. I think that was more of a safe call. The last thing this offense wants to do is take a shot downfield and cause some kind of turnover.
And it's good. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Throws left, the running back's got it, and they make the stop at the 25. That makes it second and 10. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Get up, get up, get up, get up. stretch out. Got the corner. He's to the 40. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
Taken down around the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line. First down. Just throws this one away. The 39-yard line.
No gain on the play. That'll make it 39.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29.
Man left, man left. Down.
He guns it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
If he hits this, we're all tied up. Kicks up. And he got it.
Great snap and a perfect hold. And he just had an awesome follow-through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
3-3 tie. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Thomas fields it at the 13. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over.
They bring him down in the backfield. Second and 11. Ball on their own 24.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Wants to throw outside.
The deflection prevented them from getting any yards, and now it's fourth down.
Ruiz to punt. Washington fields it at the 34, and he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
Gains his way to the 39-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. It's a great run, and he's brought down in the backfield. The play of this defensive end.
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
And they hit him in the backfield. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper. A loss of one. From the 41-yard line. Third down. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. So at the end of one. And this one's knotted up at three.
set to resume action here in the second quarter. We've got a tight ball game.
Scrambling around. And down he goes.
Around the 21-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 21. Blackburn gets about a yard on the play.
He's in trouble.
And a quick throw. Tackle at the 1 yard line. First down. And they'll bring it up first and goal inside the 5. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D.
And they'll score.
PAT. So that's an 8-play, 52-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Leonard on the handoff. He fights forward to about the 26. And he gets a yard on the run.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there.
Second and 9. Ball on the 26. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
It's third and 11. Ball on the 24-yard line. 5 wide.
And he's taken down
right around the 32-yard line.
He's to the 40.
Gets to about the 37-yard line.
This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Clipping. Receiving team.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 22.
He's out to the 30. He gets hit out of bounds at the 34.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
And he hits him hard at the 46.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
From their own 46-yard line. It's first down.
Brought down at the
42-yard line. The halfback took the pitch but couldn't find any running lanes.
And there were no running lanes because his defense had so much penetration into the backfield. He would have been lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Quick throw. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. Into that quickly. And he's tackled right around the 14-yard line.
The offense caught him flat-footed to convert that third and long. You can tell by the coach's reaction that that is a huge disappointment.
He fights forward to about the 13. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Gives it to the back. That's a great tackle at the 13. This is the eighth play of this drive. And a man open, touchdown. Converts the extra point. An eight-play, 76-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 17-3. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Mustangs know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Slings it. Tackle made right around the 48-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
From the 48-yard line, first down. He's level at the 43-yard line. The Mustangs use their second timeout. They come out on an empty backfield. Caught with room to work. Out of bounds at the 39. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Set up a first and goal. Now he's scrambling. And he is drilled at the 2-yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. The receiver for six.
And the receiver does a nice job here of fighting off the defender to get to the ball. That was a nice pitch and catch.
makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
He's on the run, and he can't get away from the pressure. From their own 29-yard line, it's third down. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 17-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense is coming out on the field, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone lately. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. They'll bring him down around the 29-yard line. Here's a run. And they make the stop at about the 27-yard line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. Thomas fields it at the 30. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Here we go. Hand off, and he's met immediately. No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 36. Tries to buy some time. He's taken down at about the 47-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Right, left, right, left.
a wide out, and he can't pull it in.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. And down he goes, around the 40-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 40. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Throws left, picked off. Not a good decision there. Why'd he even throw that pass?
Well, it's a good job by the corner of sitting back and reading the quarterback's eyes. Good job of disguising coverage as well.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. He's at midfield, makes it to the 47. From the 43-yard line, second down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Tackle at the 36-yard line. Looking to capitalize on the big run. It's now first and goal. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
He gets out to about the 6-yard line.
That makes it third and goal.
It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. Lane goes with a play fake. Off the fake. Touchdown!
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
And he hits the PAT. It was a 7-play, 62-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's scrambling, decides to slide. It's second and seven. Ball on the 28-yard line. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's out of bounds around the 34-yard line. Puts it away, and it's a great kick. Washington takes it at the 20. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. You know, going in at halftime, a tight ball game. Coming out here in the third quarter, we know both these coaches, and one guy is simmering right now. The other guy's got his team simmering.
Well, this offensive coordinator is recognized as one of the top in the business. And I think as we've seen the adjustments he made at halftime, it's allowed this offense to go out, execute that plan, and now all of a sudden they've got a nice big lead.
Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run, and he's brought down. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Pitch out, got the corner, knocked out of bounds at about the 49. Tackle after a decent pickup. Blackburn gets about 4 yards on the play. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. He laterals. Makes it out to about the 30. On the play. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. They'll knock him down for a loss. Scrambling around. And he's tackled at the 11-yard line.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. gets it up the middle for a nice run.
A nice option play. The tailback gets 6 yards before he's brought down. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. The Mustangs are going to call their second timeout. Copeland gains around 2 yards there on the option. This is the 10th play of this drive. A short yardage defense here. And it pays off. Touchdown. And that rushing touchdown should put this one away, Kirk. Converts the extra point. A nice 10-play, 64-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Taken at the 5. Room around the corner. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. Though you've got to tip your hat to the defense. They've played well today.
This defense has done everything that's asked of them. They've slowed down the opposing offense. They've created turnovers. They've got pressure on the quarterback. In these last couple drives, they've just played probably the best they've played all game.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
The spike will stop the clock.
That'll make it third and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Just under 2 minutes in the game. With the pass, incomplete.
That would have been a great play if the throw were just a little bit more on target.
He's got room. He's tackled around the 33-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Slings it out there incomplete. From the 33-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a 5-wide set. And he's taken down the 17-yard line. Just throws this one away. And this is the 10th play of the drive. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
From the 17-yard line, it's third down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and goal.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Just over a minute left. And he's got the touchdown. So it's the Big Hoss on the score.
And I think the fullbacks deserve to get some of the spotlight. They're always out there working hard for everybody else. They're like a glorified offensive lineman. They never get any recognition.
And he tacks on the extra point. And now things have gotten a little more interesting.
Brad, this one's not over yet. Watch out now, because the momentum has completely shifted.
These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another 6 on the board here.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Boy, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Fires to his receiver, first down.
That makes it first and ten.
Five wide. He's got it with room to run. And they push him out around the 25-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down at about the 15-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
The stop at the 1 yard line. Spikes the ball. Here's the eighth play of the series. They come out in an empty backfield. Got his receiver, touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. Brought down at the 43. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. The Mustangs are going to have to call their third and final timeout. Takes a knee. The finish here today. The Rangers, 31. The Mustangs, 24. So that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.